Hi, this is Dr. Martha Bacon Crawford, otherwise known as Mars, and I have been at SAS for 24 years.
Hi, my name is Chris Munden. This is my sixth year at SAS.
Hi, I'm Mara Stewart, and I've been at SAS for, this is my fourth year.
And this is my
62nd
selfie.
I think Mr. Munden is from the Philippines.
I think Chris is from the Philippines because he's mentioned that he is Filipino.
I am from all over the place. I was born in Saudi Arabia. I went to high school in the Philippines. I went to college in the US and I've lived all over the world. So I am from everywhere.
I think Mary Stewart is from California.
I think she's from New Zealand because there are a lot of sheep and grass and it's really green and beautiful. And I think as a nature enthusiast, she would really love the environment.
I am originally from South Carolina. I've lived a little bit all over the United States, and this is my third country.
I think Ms. Bacon is from the US.
She is from America.
I think she's from the United States.
I am from California.
My proudest accomplishment.
I think his proudest accomplishment would, be joining Quest because it's awesome.
Oh, I'm proud of a lot of my accomplishments, but I think like being a faculty member here at SAS is definitely one of my proudest accomplishments.
Ms. Bacon's proudest accomplishment is probably being a Quest teacher.
Joining Quest and teaching the Quest students because we're awesome, obviously.
Learning how to scuba dive.
My proudest accomplishment is earning my doctorate from University of Southern California.
My proudest accomplishment, other than being a parent and a wife, I would say
completing the Marines because I know she was a part of that.
Finally determining that education is where I feel like I was meant to be. And so getting to kind of do what I love and love what I do, that to me is like the greatest accomplishment of anyone.
What was the first thing that I do when I wake up in the morning?
Aside from like the normal things that one would do?
Okay, I'm not gonna lie. It's like check my phone.
Yeah, brush my teeth.
I am a very lucky spouse of Fred Crawford who brings me a cup of coffee every single morning.
Ooh, favorite dish in Singapore.
It's chicken rice.
It's chicken rice.
Chicken rice?
I'm gonna guess chicken rice.
I mean, come on, chicken rice is everyone's favorite dish, right?
My favorite Singaporean dish is laksa.
Hands down, it's laksa, and I may have actually told my husband when we first visited Singapore that laksa and kaya toast was reason enough. That was a good enough reason to move to Singapore.
My favorite Singaporean dish, oh, this is a tough one. Chicken rice, cereal prawns.
One city on my bucket list is?
I think is Dubrovnik.
Reykjavik in Iceland.
Oh, one that is, okay, so there's like these fake cities in China that they like recreate other cities, so like ones that look like other cities. That's definitely on my list, because that's interesting.
If I was not in the education industry, I would be...
Do something with food. Heard talking about it a lot.
A foodie, something with food.
Either a pilot or doing something related to food.
If she was not in the education industry, she would be a gym teacher.
Be an environmentalist.
A conservationist.
I would probably find a way to blend what I did before I became a teacher, where I was doing environmental ed, with what I love and some of the best parts of teaching. And so I think I would probably be like one of those people that when you go on interim and you're spending time with those people who are organizing all of the trips, that probably would be me.
If she was not in the education industry, she would probably be somewhere scuba diving, collecting plastic in the ocean to save sea creatures.
If I was not in the education industry, I would be working for the United Nations Development Program, and I would be a professional there.
Three words to describe me. Talkative, passionate, and I can't say talkative again. So I would say maybe bubbly.
Joyful, driven, and fun-loving.
Roller coaster emotions, very interested a learner, and very satisfied and happy mother.
I decided to teach Quest because
he was involved in the whole sixth grade, interdisciplinary learning thing, and
having a chance to do it with high school seemed pretty cool.
I really think that interdisciplinary learning is the way of the future.
After my dissertation, I was convinced about personalized learning, interdisciplinary approach to learning, and empowering students to follow their own personalized approach to learning.
It's like the very best of like what over 100 years of research has said of what education should be. And oftentimes there's too many things that stand in the way of teachers who really want to do the things that Quest is doing, and we have the opportunity to fully immerse ourselves in students in doing experiential ed, doing service learning, getting students out there in the real work. That's really why I'm doing it, because it is the best of education.
Have I ever been sent to the principal's office, or why? No, in my time, I was never sent to the principal's office, but I do come to the principal's office to chat now and again.
No, I've never been sent to the principal's office. I was a really, really good kid.
Mayor Stewart has ever been sent to the principal's office, and why? I don't think she was sent to the principal's office.
I don't think she's ever been sent to the principal's office.
I think she has been sent to the principal's office because she probably told a teacher that they shouldn't be using plastic.
Yeah, I've been to the principal's office. I'm not gonna say why. That's confidential.